today we are going to discuss about advanced IC engine. So in this advanced IC engine, we are going to discuss about S.I. engine, so spark ignition engine. So in this spark ignition engine, here we are going to discuss about air fuel ratio requirement and then various stages of combustion, normal combustion as well as abnormal combustion, and then factors affecting knock, and then introduction to thermodynamic analysis of S.I. systems. So here we are going to discuss about that carburation. So what is carburation? Is nothing but mixing of air and then fuel ratio. So normally in petrol engines, that is S.I. engines, we will use air as well as petrol will get mixed in that carburetor. So nowadays in advanced carburetor, so there is no carburetor. Instead of carburetor, we are introducing the direct injection system. So directly that petrol will be get injected into the engine cylinder. So previous days they are using this carburetor. In this carburetor, the petrol will get mixed with that air. So there is one standard ratio for this air fuel mixer. So which will be air fuel mixer, which will be around 15:1 ratio. So air will be in 15% and then fuel will be 1. So the ratio will be in the order of 15:1, which is known as stoichiometric air fuel ratio. So here, in this carburetion, here what we are doing is we are going to see that it will depend upon that ambient air condition. So depending upon that atmospheric air condition, so if the temperature of air as well as outside temperature also, it will affect that carburetion. So if the temperature is very less, now the efficiency will be very less. So if that atmospheric air temperature is high, then the efficiency of that carburetion will get increased. And then fuel characteristic. So if the carburetion will also depend upon the fuel characteristics. So if there is volatile component, that is volatile HC is very important for this vaporization of that petrol. So if that volatile VC component, HC component is more, so easily the petrol will get evaporated and then it will get mixed with the air and then it will be injected into that engine cylinder. So next, depending upon the engine speed as well as load. So when the engine starts running at a high speed, so what happens is, so there we have to supply more petrol than that of air. So at that time what we have to do is, so more amount of petrol has to be injected. So at that time what they are here we are doing is, we are introducing a apparatus that is which is known as venturi. So venturi is nothing but a small nozzle. So in that nozzle, what happens is, due to that high pressure, so enormous amount of fuel will be injected into that air fuel mixer, so that when the speed get increased, so the mixture, rich mixture will be entered into that engine cylinder. At the same time, when the load is also high, automatically through that venturi, enormous amount of petrol will be injected. And then next, depending upon, there are different types of air fuel mixer. So three different types of air fuel mixer are here. So one is chemically correct mixer, another one is rich mixer, another one is lean mixer. So chemically correct mixer is nothing but the ratio will be in stoichiometric ratio. Stoichiometric ratio is nothing but petrol will be in the ratio of 1 and then air will be in ratio of 15. So 15:1 ratio is known as chemically correct mixer. And then rich mixer is during idling condition as well as high speed condition. So during idling condition also, what happens is, enormous amount of due to that engine is not running, so enormous amount of fuel will be injected into that engine cylinder. At the same time, which is known as lean mixer. Lean mixer, the ratio will be greater than that, air will be greater than that of petrol. So here we are going to see that range, so which is known as lean mixer and then which is known as rich mixer. So here for rich mixer, the ratio will be around 9:1, and then starting from 15:1, starting from 15:1 to 9, from 9:1 to 15:1, you will have rich mixer. Starting from 15:1 to 19:1, you are having lean mixer. So that in that lean mixer, the air content will be more than that of stoichiometric mixer. So here in this graph, here you have given a graph for brake specific fuel consumption as well as air fuel ratio and then power output. So here, depending upon that power, So here in that air fuel mixer, so in that center here you are having that stoichiometric ratio 15:1. So here in that when you will have power output more is nothing but, so when you are having rich mixer, the power output will be more. So in the ratio of 12:1, so when the air fuel mixer is about 12:1, you will have maximum power output, that is less than that of, that is rich mixer will be there, that is less than that of stoichiometric ratio. So after stoichiometric ratio, what you are having is, so after, that is in that lean mixer, you are having brake specific fuel consumption, that is maximum power output will be here in this, when the mixer is rich mixer, you will have maximum power output, and then when there is lean mixer, you will have specific fuel consumption will be very very less, fuel consumption will be less when you are running that engine in lean condition, that is lean mixer. So next, there are, what are all the requirement for different condition for air fuel mixer. So here as already told, so best economy mixer is nothing but, so when that basic fuel consumption will be in that lean mixer, so when that area is in that lean mixer, you will have best fuel economy mixer, as well as high power ratio you will get when there is a rich mixer, you will have, that is in the ratio of 12:1, you will have that high power consumption. So here you are having three different stages in this diagram, you are having a air fuel ratio as well as throttle opening, you are having a graph. So here in the idling, maximum amount of fuel will be consumed in this area, so maximum amount of fuel will be here comparing to that of normal running condition. So initially when you are starting an engine, so enormous amount of petrol will be required to start that engine, so that here in that idling condition, the air fuel mixer enormous amount of fuel will be injected through that main chute, and then here after a particular time, okay, after a particular time automatically the fuel, air fuel requirement will be idle, that is same amount of fuel will be consumed from a particular point to another point. So after that, when the high power condition la, again the usage of petrol will get increased, so from 3 to 4 usage of petrol will be more than that of normal running condition. Next slide. So here these are all the idling condition. During idling, the engine operates at no load as well as closed throttle, so enormous amount of petrol will be used, and then here exhaust gas dilution also prevents efficient combustion by reducing the contact between the fuel as well as air particles. So here dilution is also, the when the exhaust gas is escaping, so escaping from that exhaust valve, so at that time what happens is, so due to that scavenging, there is a fresh air fuel mixer will push that exhaust gases away, so at that time also what happens is it will push that, so some amount of fresh mixer also will get escaped from that exhaust valve. So next up, next is nothing but cruising range. So cruising range, no exhaust dilution takes place, so exhaust gases will be separate, so that there will be no connection between that both inlet fresh air fuel mixer as well as exhaust air fuel mixer. And then in that power range, what happens is, as the high power is required, so here also what it has to do is, the additional fuel has to be supplied in order to maintain that mixer, so that through that venturi, enormous amount will be injected into that engine cylinder. And then in that rich mixer, it also prevents that overheating by reducing that flame temperature of that cylinder temperature. So in that when enormous amount of fuel is supplied into that engine cylinder, automatically that engine valve cylinder temperature also increases, so that what happens is knock formation is also eliminated, so due to that higher temperature there will be knock also will get eliminated. So next, this is a basic simple carburetor. Normally this carburetor works, these are all the various parts. So here you are having that fuel tank, so in this fuel tank you are having a float, So this float, what it is doing is nothing but it controls that flow of petrol inside that. So here you are having strainer. So strainer la, the petrol is entering into that strainer. So the dust particles will get filtered in this strainer, and then the petrol will be entering into this petrol tank. So from this petrol tank, that float water, what it is doing is nothing but it controls that fuel entering into the fuel tank. So from this, it is connected to that. So this is the air passage. So this is the throttle valve. So use of throttle valve is nothing but which controls the air. So atmospheric air will pass into this pipe. So this throttle valve controls that fuel, that is air entering into this. And then here you are, it will be connected to here you are having that in that outlet of the flow pipe. Flow pipe from this petrol tank. Here you are having a venturi, that is venturi nozzle. So in this nozzle, due to the pressure difference between the atmospheric pressure as well as here nozzle pressure, so due to that pressure difference, automatically that fuel will get injected into the through this pipe. So here we are having choke valve. So choke valve just it regulates the flow of air fuel mixer which is entering into the engine. So here very very important is here venturi, due to the area is reduced here, so automatically the pressure will get increased. So due to this reduction of area, the pressure will get increased, but here you are having atmospheric pressure inside this. And since this tank is in open condition, the pressure inside that tank will be in atmospheric condition. So here due to that pressure difference, here that area is reduced, due to the pressure difference the petrol will get injected into the air pipe, so that air and fuel will get mixed and then it will get entered into the engine cylinder. Next slide. So this is the principle of working operation of that carburetor. So here you are having that the carburetor works on the Bernoulli's principle, so that the faster air moves, the lower it's the static pressure, so that the higher dynamic pressure will be there. And then due to that float which is present inside that tank, which will control the flow of petrol inside the venturi. Next slide. So these are also the operation of that simple carburetor. So the principle of operation of simple carburetor. So when the system operates at starting and setting off, when 20% of the throttle is reached. So when the 20% of the throttle is reached, so automatically that air fuel mixer will get increased. So next, the idling air blade sucks the some air for mixing the idle fuel as well as and vaporizes the mixer. The additional air fuel mixer makes that mixer rich for idling. So during the idling condition, what happens is more amount of petrol will get mixed with the air. And then for power, whenever you are having high power also, the rich mixer will be injected into the engine cylinder. So compensating systems in the carburetor. So here you are having some compensating system. So why you are having compensating system is, so depending upon the atmospheric condition as well as load condition of that engine cylinder, you are having number of compensating mechanism for the carburetor. So one is air bleed jet, compensating jet, emulsion tube, back suction control mechanism, axillary air valve, axillary air port, and then attitude compensating devices. So next. So here you are having air bleed jet. So air bleed jet is nothing but here you are having that air bleed jet, you are having one separate air bleed. So in which air, atmospheric air will enter into that, enter into this air fuel mixer. So at starting condition, what will be here is, so at before engine starting position, so here instead of air, it will be filled with fuel. That petrol, whichever is from the tank, will enter into this air bleed. So whenever before starting of that engine, the air bleed will be filled with petrol. So after after that engine gets started, automatically the petrol whichever is present in this air bleed will enter into this air fuel chamber. After that, here from from the bottom of the air, atmospheric air will enter into this, and then here both the air and petrol will get mixed. After that it will flow through this air fuel pipe. So after working condition, the whichever petrol present in that air bleed tube will enter into that venturi, and then the petrol will get mixed. After that it will exit from the pipe and then it will enter into the engine cylinder. So after that only air will enter. So it will support that due to the pressure difference between the atmospheric pressure as well as in this pipe pressure, automatically the petrol will get mixed inside the pipe. Next slide. And then here this is compensating jet. So this compensating jet is also used whenever you are having a deficiency of air, whichever used for the carburetor. So carburetor, if the air is deficiency, no, automatically here also you will have in that. So here you are having two pipes from that petrol tank. You are having two outlet you are having here. So one is a regular pipe whichever is used for injecting that petrol which mix with that air, and then another one is compensating pipe. So in that compensating pipe flow, what happens is, so excess fuel, when the load in that engine increases, so that air fuel mixer will you have to supply more petrol inside the air fuel mixer, so excess amount of petrol will be sent into the pipe, so that excess amount which will be get compensated. So here you will have venturi pipe, and then here you will have compensating jet. So next slide is emulsion tube. So emulsion tube is nothing but you are mixing that petrol and then air, so you will have a emulsion, that is a liquid as well as air, so both will get mixed, and then here you will have a emulsion in this tube. So after that air fuel mixer, after getting that emulsion mixer, it will enter into the pipe. So here you are having a throttle valve. The throttle valve will regulate the air fuel supply whichever is entering into the engine cylinder. And then next is back suction control mechanism. So back suction control mechanism, here you are having these are all the various parts you are having. So here you are having one control valve. So this control valve, what happens is it will create pressure difference between the pump, pressure difference between the petrol tank as well as the pipe whichever is connecting that engine cylinder. So if the control valve gets open, automatically that air whichever is entering into that pipe, which will increase the pressure inside the fuel tank, so that excess amount of fuel will be supplied here. So whenever it is in off condition, that is whenever the control valve is in closed condition, automatically normal working condition will be there. That is normal petrol, normal, that is a stoichiometric ratio, whichever is in the ratio of 16:1, air fuel ratio will be supplied. So if you want to increase that petrol, so at that time alone we have to remove this control, that is you have to remove this control valve, so that excess pressure will be entered into the tank, so that excess amount of fuel will be supplied into the engine cylinder. Next is axillary air valve. Here we are supplying excess air. So in the previous slide we have seen that we are supplying excess petrol in order to compensate that high power. So here you are supplying excess fuel. Next slide. And then this is axillary air port. So just we are making a bypass, that is instead of air directly entering into that engine cylinder, here you are making some bypass, that is few amount of 20% of that air whichever is entering into that pipe is sent is get pipe bypassed, and then again it is allowed to pass through the pipe, so that air and fuel will get mixed, and then it will be entered into the engine cylinder. Compensating system. So these are all the various compensating systems used in that carburetor. So combustion, here you are having two different types of combustion. One is normal combustion as well as abnormal combustion. So normal combustion is whenever the ratio of whenever the carbon content as well as hydrogen content will be, whenever the carbon content as well as hydrogen content will be in same proportion, so at that time the normal combustion takes place. Abnormal combustion on the due to some reasons on the there will be some abnormal combustion. So whenever the flame temperature, whichever is entering into the engine cylinder, if the flame temperature is higher than that of 2000 degree centigrade, so due to that higher temperature, so excess amount of carbon will be released, so that abnormal combustion will be there. So due to that abnormal combustion, the emission of CO, that is carbon monoxide, will be more compared to that of normal combustion. So in that abnormal combustion, pollution whenever abnormal combustion is there. So abnormal combustion is nothing but combustion does not take place properly. If the combustion takes place properly, you will have the exit will be carbon content will be converted into carbon dioxide CO2, as well as carbon will be converted into CO2, hydrogen whichever present in that petrol will be converted into H2O. In that abnormal combustion, carbon will not get converted into carbon dioxide, instead it will be converted into carbon monoxide. So carbon monoxide, which affects that ozone, and then it will deplete that ozone layer. Next slide. So these are all that combustion whichever takes place in that SI. So here these are all the various three stages of combustion. So here three stages are here: preparation phase, flame propagation phase, and then after burning phase. So preparation phase la what you are having is, so preparation phase la here the here in the x-axis you are having that crank angle rotation, that is starting from 0 to 1 revolution, here you have taken here, and then in that y direction that pressure whichever is developed in inside that combustion chamber. So inside that combustion chamber what happens is, so three phases la that burning takes place. So burning at that preparation second phase what happens is, in that flame propagation phase la high temperature will be generated. So after burning la the temperature automatically decreases, that is in that exhaust whichever temperature present in that combustion will not be there in that exhaust phase. So the temperature will get reduced. So these are all the various phases here explained. So now the preparation phase and it will be when the combustion after suction compression will take place. After compression on the high amount of using spark plug, the temperature will get increased, so that in that preparation phase la what happens is the high temperature will be created in the after compression. Next slide. So these are all that various three phases. Thank you.